I found a great way to spruce up your intranet, department homepage, or any other page in SharePoint. It's 100% free, and it's really, really simple to set up. Even better, it's using out-of-the-box SharePoint features. I'll also show you how this whole thing works so you can tweak it however you'd like. Let's get into it. So what is this new thing? Is this a web part? It's actually just a list. It's using a list to present a numbered list on a SharePoint page in a really, really nice way. It's ordered a 1, 2, 3, 4, but you could of course change that when I show you how this thing works. So let's jump into SharePoint and show you how to set this thing up from scratch. So I'm on my IT site. If we just go to site contents, and we create a new list. I'll just call this Tech Tips. Don't want it shown in site navigation because this is just going to be the backend interface. Users will never need to see this list at all. This is going to create our brand new list, and all we have to do is add one column to it. So if we just go to Add Column, we're going to add multiple lines of text. And then we'll call it description. But we need to make one change to this. We need to go to more options, and we need to make sure that enhanced rich text is turned off. If you created your column a different way, this may be defaulted to on. We need enhanced the rich text editor turned off for this. So now we'll click on save. And that's it for the list. All we have to do is copy data to it. Now, if I go back to site contents, you'll see a list that's already set up. I just followed the exact same process. I called mine homepage list, and I've got my rows of text here. Now, the title column is going to be the headline of each of these numbered items. And then the description is going to be shown below that. Now, to apply this formatting, we're going to need to go to this sample, and there's a link in the description below. But don't go anywhere just yet, because I need to show you exactly how this thing works, because there's a couple of different ways you could use this. There's some tweaks so that you can customize things. But what we're going to do is go to the numbered cards JSON file, and we'll click the copy raw file button right here. And then once we've done that, we need to create a new view, because our formatter is going to be applied to the view. So we're going to click add view, and then we can type in formatted list, and that'll work. Any name you want really is going to work, because the users aren't really ever going to see this. We'll just keep this as a list view. It does need to be a public view, and we'll click create. Now, once we've done that, we click the down arrow next to the formatted list view header, and we go to format current view, and then we go down to advanced mode. Now we're just going to select everything here, hit delete, and then we'll paste in that JSON code that we copied from the other page, and then just click save. And that's it. We can close this with this pane out, this panel. And so this is our list. This is our formatted list. You could use this just like this, but we want this on a SharePoint page. So there's another step that is involved with this. Let's go back to the home page. And then we can scroll down. You'll actually see another view, that test view that you might have noticed right here. We're going to edit this, and then we'll add one from scratch. So we'll create a new web part. It's going to be list. So we're going to add the list web part to the page. And then it'll ask us which list we want to use. I want to use homepage list because that's the one I've already got my data in, just so that you don't have to see me copy list rows from one list to another. So I'll pick homepage list. Then I need to configure this list. Now, once we've got the web part properties up for our list web part, we need to change a few things. First, the view, we want to change that to the view that we created. That way it starts to show with our custom formatting. Size, and you can control size if you want. In this case, I think it's better for auto size, but if you want to force it to be shorter and there could be a scroll bar, you have that option right here. but we want to turn off the command bar. So we set that to hide command bar, and then we want to hide the see all button. Once you've done that, click apply, and then just republish the page. And that does it for this basic version of this. There's also another version, but there's some important things you need to understand because that'll help you to tweak this just the way you want. So let's jump back over to the JSON solution. And there's a link in the description below for how to find this thing. But first, I just want to point out, just right off the start, a big shout out to Tanel Vach. I believe that's how you pronounce that name. Tanel created this and submitted it to the Microsoft 365 and Power Platform Community GitHub repo, where a whole bunch of these JSON samples are that I've been showcasing. So big shout out to Tanel. Thank you so much for this. This is incredible. You'll see an image of what this thing's going to look like. And then you'll see actually two different versions here, because one of them is going to be the one, well, that's the one that we showed, is this bottom one, where it's using the site colors. And the other one is going to be using a custom image that you can specify. So if you don't want it to use the site colors, you want a custom image, then you can use that. But let's jump into the JSON that we actually applied to our site. Now, I know that this JSON may look confusing, but I promise it's not as bad as it looks. In fact, I created a course to teach you exactly how to create all this stuff from scratch so that you can create your own solutions and make your intranet and site pages and list look incredible. Now, if you're interested, there's a link in the description below because it's helped out a ton of other people just like you. But let's just go through this JSON and see how this thing works. So this is a row formatter. This is, we're applying it to the view, but it's going to format an entire row of our list data at a time. That's why you'll see at the very top of this, you'll see a schema, dollar sign schema, and you'll see that it is a row formatting schema. So that's what lets SharePoint know that this is going to be formatting the entire row at a time. From here, this is using JSON just to describe some basic HTML objects that this is going to be creating on the page. It's going to create a div, which is another name for a container. And then it's going to apply some font sizes and font weights so that it gets the text size a certain way, and it's bold or normal depending on how this was set. In this case, it's semi-bold. And in this case, it's using the out-of-the-box SharePoint CSS classes to control all that stuff. So it makes it a lot easier to do that versus managing specific pixel or point sizes and specific levels of bold. It's just using the SharePoint classes to make things easier. Inside there, there's some more CSS applied to that div to set the text direction, kind of how it flows down the page. It's setting a border radius, so we have some rounded corners, very slight rounded corners. And setting margins so that there's some spacing between elements and things like that. Then we're going to create another div in here. And this is where some of the colors come into play. Here, you'll see the class attribute. It's using the theme primary. So that's actually the primary theme's color on the site. It's going to be using that. Now, by doing that, it's going to inherit the colors of whatever site it happens to be on. If your site has a red theme, then it's going to be a red background. If it's a blue theme, it'll be a blue background. The same JSON can look different on everyone, but the fact that it's using the theme colors makes it look like it's part of SharePoint. It is an amazing way to do this. I really like this, and I highly recommend always trying to use the theme colors. That way you're not ever having to go back and update this if the site owner does change the theme on that particular site. It just automatically switches over. You'll see a whole lot of CSS styles applied here just to control the positioning of the container where all the actual text is going to go into. And then inside that is actually going to be the box with the numbers that are going down for each of our list items. You'll see that the text is being set here in the text content attribute. And the text is actually set to row index plus one. You'll see an @ row index. That's always going to be whatever the list item is going down the page. plus one. So the row index is actually start at zero. So that's why there's a plus one in there. But you could change that. If you wanted it to actually start at zero, then you could just remove that plus one. Or you can do other math operators if you want something to start at 100 and then go 101, 102, maybe 100, 200, 300. You've got all sorts of options there with just some basic math to control what number is displayed on your list items. After that, there's another element that's created with a neutral lighter color. So here it's referencing the site theming as again, and this time it's using the neutral lighter color. You'll see that by this gray color right behind the change your password often and all the other text. You'll see that with the text blocks here. Because the primary theme was used for the numbers, and then the neutral lighter color for this particular site theme is used behind the text. So that's how that other background text gets there. Then there's some CSS styling just to handle the alignment where that text needs to be positioned inside this box, which is a div. And then the last major pieces of this puzzle are inside that box, we have two other text boxes. One's going to hold the title field. So that's the title of our list item. And then the description, which is the text below that. And for each of these, you'll see classes to specify the font size. In this case, the title is font size large, and the description is font size medium with a font weight of a regular. So no bold or anything like that. But you can change these around if you want to make all the text bold, or remove the description entirely if you wanted to, or maybe even remove the heading just by highlighting a particular section like the title, and then just deleting it out of there when you go paste in your JSON formatter that we did onto the view. So you can customize this in a number of different ways. Now, I've covered a lot of JSON formatting samples just like this one on my channel because there's so much in terms of free upgrades that you can give to your SharePoint sites. I've got a dedicated playlist just for these videos. So to get started with the next one, click or tap the screen and I'll see you over there.